Education is the most powerful weapon that you can use to change the world. Nelson Mandela. The truth of these words is manifest in the transformed lives of the students and alumni of historic LeMoyne Owen College. LeMoyne Owen is the heart of the Soulsville, USA Renaissance community in Memphis, Tennessee. As the only historically black college in Memphis, LeMoyne Owen College has educated local and national leaders who, with their passion and presence, have made an indelible impact on their respective communities and touched countless lives.
It feels so good to be alive. Got all my family by my side. Couldn't wipe this black off if I tried. That's why I lift my head with pride.
Shake up this world.
Giving out to them that blackness, that black power, that black pushing them to identify with black culture. I think that's what you're asking. I have no choice over it. In the first place, to me, we are the most beautiful creatures in the whole world, black people.
Don't let anybody take your man. I'm gonna get the language so right that everybody here will cry out, yes, I'm black, I'm proud of it, I'm black and beautiful.
Think again, better wake up because you're part of something way bigger. You're part of something way bigger, not just a speck in the universe, not just some words in the Bible verse. You are the living word. You're part of something way bigger, bigger than you, bigger than we, bigger than the picture they framed us to see. But now we see it, and it ain't no secret. No. You better think again. Better wake up because you're part of something way bigger. You're part of something way bigger. Not just a speck in the universe. Not just some words in the Bible verse. You are the living word. You're part of something way bigger.
Education is the most powerful weapon that you can use to change the world. Nelson Mandela. The truth of these words is manifest in the transformed lives of the students and alumni of historic LeMoyne Owen College. LeMoyne Owen is the heart of the Soulsville, USA Renaissance community in Memphis, Tennessee. As the only historically black college in Memphis, LeMoyne Owen College has educated local and national leaders who, with their passion and presence, have made an indelible impact on their respective communities and touched countless lives.
It feels so good to be alive. Got all my family by my side. this black off if I try. That's why I lift my head with pride.
Shake up this world.
Giving out to them that blackness, that black power, that black pushing them to identify with black culture. I think that's what you're asking. I have no choice over it. In the first place, to me, we are the most beautiful creatures in the whole world, black people.
Don't let anybody take your man. I'm gonna get the language so right that everybody here will cry out, yes, I'm black, I'm proud of it, I'm black and beautiful.
Shake up this world.
If you feel insignificant, you better think again. Better wake up because you're part of something way bigger. You're part of something way bigger. Not just a speck in the universe. Not just some words in the Bible verse. You are the living word. You're part of something way bigger. Bigger than you, bigger than we. Bigger than the picture they framed us to see. But now we see it. And it ain't no secret. No. You better think again. Better wake up because you're part of something way bigger. You're part of something way bigger. Not just a speck in the universe. Not just some words in the Bible verse. You are the living word. You're part of something way bigger.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain seated and receive the class of 2023. Thank you.
Good morning. Please be seated and let us pause as we allow our guests waiting in the lobby to enter. Pastor Watkins here, Mount Vernon Baptist Church, and we'd like to welcome LeMoyne Owen College back home. Scripture reading is coming from the book of Deuteronomy 31, verse 6. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified. For the Lord your God goes with you. The Lord your God will never leave you nor forsake you. The word of God for the people of God. Let us say thanks be unto God. Amen.
We invite you to pray in the spirit of love. And whatever your faith tradition leads you, pray silently as I pray aloud, would you? God, we thank you. We thank you for the spirit of perseverance and for grace, for mercy. We thank you for students that stayed up late. We thank you for single mothers that didn't know they could do it, but they did. We thank you for first-time college students, young men who didn't know that they would be the light for their family. We thank you for administration that allowed students to retake tests. We thank you for unexpected money and scholarships that people didn't know was there. We thank you for a place called LeMoyne Owen College that keeps on standing in the midst of trouble. We thank you for staff that stays up late when nobody recognizes them. We thank you for grandmothers that gave their last. We thank you for people that prayed before they went to the grave. We thank you for ancestors that went before us. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for historically black colleges and universities that continue to survive through the annals of time. We thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for being back at Mount Vernon. We thank you for keeping the legacy strong of this school that shines in Memphis when Memphis seems dark. We thank you, Lord. We ask that your presence would be here and you would be glorified in everything that we do. Lord, let us make you big and make folks smile who are even watching online. We pray this in the one and only true wise God. Amen.
Can't give up now. never said there wouldn't be trials, and never said I wouldn't fall. Never said that everything would go the way I wanted to go. But when my back is against the wall and I feel a hope is gone, I'll just lift my head up to the sky and say, help me to be strong. Oh, I just can't give up now. I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. No, he didn't bring me out here to leave me lonely, even when I can't see clearly. I know that you are with me, so I can. I just can't give up now. I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. I just can't give up now. I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. I just can't give up now. I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. I just can't give up now. I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he's brought me this far. I don't believe he brought me this far. I don't believe he's brought me this far. I don't believe he's brought me this far. I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me.
Good morning, and congratulations, magicians. I'm so proud of each and every one of you. Your journey to this moment has been filled with highs and lows, growths and successes, and some struggles and obstacles, but you've overcome each and every one of them. And now you stand ready to join the ranks of alumni, LeMoyne Owen College magicians that have gone on to make an incredible impact on the world. Your time at LOC has been impacted by world events beyond your control, including a pandemic that impacted all of us to our very core. But through virtual events and online courses, you found a way to make magic happen. You connected with your fellow students and forged lifelong bonds. You learned from faculty in new and innovative ways, and as a result, you're ready to enter and thrive in a 21st century workforce. And through it all, you experienced a renaissance, a resurgence of LeMoyne Owen College that continues to this day. Students, the students are the reason for that resurgence. Every trustee, faculty, staff, and executive member worked hard each and every day for your betterment in mind. And I hope you see the effects of their dedication and that it magnifies every moment of your lives. You may be leaving LeMoyne Owen College today, but you will find that you'll be in this family always. Your hard work, dedication, they've not gone unnoticed. And now the world is ready to see your impact. You are ready. You have been excellently prepared and divinely ordered for your next steps in this life. It is now time for you to lead, to seize every opportunity, and to create meaningful, impactful change in every area of your lives. You are change makers, you are magic makers, and your magic never stops. At this time, we will hear greetings from your 2023 class valedictorian, Mr. Michael Zhao.
A pleasant morning to you all, and a warm welcome to our president, Dr. Bennett Furze, the respected Board of Trustees, our esteemed faculty and staff, honored guests, beloved family and friends, and my fellow graduates. Some of you may know me, but to those who don't, my name is Michael Zhou, and I am an international student from Zimbabwe. It is an honor to stand before you today as we are gathered here to celebrate our achievements. I am filled with a sense of pride and gratitude for everything that we have accomplished together. It is not a secret that the road has been long and challenging for us all. I remember we started our freshman year with excitement and enthusiasm, only to be disrupted by the pandemic in the second semester. It was a very difficult time for everyone as we were faced with the task of adapting to online learning and figuring out ways to stay connected with our professors, classmates, and friends. Despite all these challenges and setbacks, we have emerged stronger, wiser, and more determined than ever before, and that is why we are here today. As we move into the next stage of our lives, I encourage my fellow graduates to reflect on the lessons we have learned, the lifelong friendships we have made, and the memories we have created. We have learned that hard work and dedication can take us further in life than we ever thought possible, and that failure is not a setback, but it is an opportunity to learn and grow from our mistakes. I would be negligent if I did not take this opportunity to express my gratitude to the faculty and staff of LeMoyne Owen College. Thank you for being outstanding mentors and educators, and for helping us to become the best versions of ourselves. Additionally, I would like to extend my appreciation to the Computer Science Department for their guidance and dedication in providing me and my fellow computer science students with the necessary skills to excel in the technology industry. I would also like to thank Dr. June from the bottom of my heart for everything that she has done for me and other international students. She welcomed us to LeMoyne Owen College with open arms and made us feel at home from the very beginning. I hope that her kindness and support will continue to inspire and benefit future international students. Last but not least, I would like to take a moment to express my deepest appreciation to my family here today, those watching from home, and a special mention to my father, who is no longer with us, but definitely cheering me on from heaven. Thank you for being my biggest supporters and for believing in me even when I doubted myself. Thank you for being my biggest supporters. Your presence in my life has made all the difference, and I am forever grateful for your love and support. In my language, we say maitabasa, which translates to thank you. So thank you again, and congratulations to the class of 2023.
Job well done, job well done. Good morning, everyone. And thank you so much for being here today. I'm Patricia Covington, chair of the board of LeMoyne Owen College, and I stand before you representing the board this morning. We want to say congratulations to the graduating class of LeMoyne Owen College. You should be proud of yourselves. You should be more than proud of yourselves. You have worked hard, you have accomplished much. Your work and your dedication, as well as your perseverance, have paid off. You did it. Your time at LeMoyne Owen College has been filled with lots of resilience. You've not had it easy. Through the pandemic, you've seen the spirit of LeMoyne Owen College persevere, and you've kept marching right along. That was not an easy task. Through the transition to hybrid classes and virtual events, you kept going and you made the best of a very uncertain world. I implore you to keep that energy in life. Life's toughest moments often make us stronger. I hope you see these obstacles and that you've made they've made you stronger, and they've helped you understand how to thrive in a very complex world. Milestones are not easy to get to. You have gotten to a great milestone in your life. Without question, you are ready. You are ready for the next steps in life. You may ask yourself, have I done all I can to prepare for this moment? Let me tell you something. You are prepared. You have the blueprint and the foundation to keep building and growing. Don't ever stop learning. Both I and Vice Chairman Don Comer are both back in school, continuing our own educations. Don't ever stop learning. We are all students in this walk of life. As Chair of the Board of Trustees, I want to say on behalf of all of us how excited we are. So very excited to see you sitting here today. Our guiding work as a board is to ensure the excellence of your education, and we take that very seriously. We hope that your time at LeMoyne Owen has provided you with the skill set to reach every single goal in your life. We challenge you to never stop striving. Keep pushing for greater. It's out there. Keep going for better. It's out there. Keep going for higher. It's up there. Know that every accolade, every new accomplishment and award that you bring along in life, sprinkle some of your magic spirit on it. You're a magician for a reason. You have the magic. Use it. When you get your seat at the table, use it. It's not an easy seat to get. You have the magic spirit. You have your faith, and you have everything that you need to undergird you. It is my hope and the hope of the board of LeMoyne Owen College that we have prepared you and strengthened you, and that you will leave this campus and enter into the world ready to make a change. It is my hope that you are ready to lead and that you take the opportunities and the advantage of life to advance change. I'd like to share a quote from the great Nelson Mandela. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. That is your responsibility as a graduate of LeMoyne Owen College. We know your impact will be great. We don't question that. And we can't wait to see how far you actually soar. My charge to you is to keep the LeMoyne Owen spirit close. Become active alumni in your communities and open the door for others to walk through. In everything you do, remember to sprinkle a little bit of magic. Your magic, that LOC magic. You have it, and you have most certainly earned it. At this time, the LeMoyne Owen College Board of Trustees would like to take a moment to recognize the service of two very special trustees, Mr. Herman Strickland and Dr. Beverly Williams Cleaves, who both, in their own right, exemplified the unending service and dedication that LeMoyne inspires. Dr. Williams Cleaves and Mr. Strickland both unfortunately passed during their tenure as trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, but their legacy continues. These two trustees worked tirelessly, and I say that without hesitation, tirelessly, in furthering the goals and the well-being of the college. Their service and tenure as trustees should not go unrecognized. At this time, would the family of Dr. Beverly Williams Cleaves and Mr. Herman Strickland please stand? We want to say thank you, a very heartfelt thank you. Thank you for the time that they spent. Thank you for the time that you had away from your loved ones because they were doing the work of LeMoyne Owen College. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for the generosity. A plaque will be dedicated in Brownlee Hall to honor the service of Trustee Cleaves and Trustee Strickland. We thank them for their service. And we also again thank you, their beloved family, as we realize that the time spent on LeMoyne Owen College business was time not spent with you. Thank you for supporting them and giving them that time the efforts and the financial support that they both collectively and individually brought to the college to support the school and the community was both a really, really big part of their hearts. We sincerely hope this honors their service to LeMoyne Owen College. And again, we thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker. Mrs. Nzinga Zing Shaw joined the Recording Academy Grammys in 2023, where she serves as the Chief Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Officer. She leads their DEI Center of Excellence, which supports a more inclusive culture for an array of music professionals. She has also been a pioneer of diversity and inclusion across many sectors, including Starbucks and the NBA. Additionally, she is a global DEI speaker represented by Creative Artists Agency, CAA, the world's leading speakers bureau that offers a comprehensive roster of the most acclaimed speaker clients whose topics include business, cultural commentary, print and broadcast media, wellness and inspiration, and the arts and entertainment. Shaw has been recognized with numerous 40 Under 40 awards from the likes of Sports Business Journal, Atlanta Business Chronicle, The Network Journal, and PR Week. She currently serves as the board on the board of trustees of Fisk University, the board of directors of ColorCom, the board of advisors of Arctos Sports Partners, the board of directors of the Veritas School of Social Sciences, a global advisor to Velocity Global and Tempus X, and she was appointed by the 39th United States President Jimmy Carter to serve a 6-year term on the board of counselors of the Carter Center. Please join me in welcoming our 2023 commencement speaker, Mrs. Nzinga Shaw.
LeMoyne Owen College, it's graduation day, and we feel nothing but pride and joy. Greetings, President Bennett Fairs, Vice President of Student Affairs, Dr. Tara Dunn Ross, Board Chair, Patricia Covington, the distinguished Board of Trustees, Pastor Melvin D. Watkins, faculty, staff, and administrators. Thank you for your hard work, high standards, and enormous commitment to enhancing the lives of your students and providing an unmatched academic experience here at LeMoyne Owen College. Not everyone gets to eat on Fried Chicken Monday or Fried Fish Friday. Not everyone gets to dance the bunny hop on the yard or gather at Greek Row during homecoming. Oh, y'all didn't know I know about LeMoyne Owen College. But most certainly, only a chosen few graduate from one of the 107 historically Black colleges and universities in our nation. So when you tell someone that you are a graduate of the best HBCU in the world, say it with pride, say it with confidence, and remember, many are called, but few are chosen. To the graduates, you are the reason that I am here. But trust me, I know that I am not the reason that you are here. You are not here because of the speaker standing in front of you, but because of the support system sitting behind you. To the family and friends of these exceptional students, thank you for your unconditional love and ongoing encouragement of today's graduates. You are a part of their story and have played an integral role in helping them get to the point of reaching this incredible milestone, a college degree. So to the parents, grandparents, siblings, aunts, uncles, cousins, and friends and mentors, give yourselves a round of applause for having a hand in their success.
and for always believing in them. Most of all, greetings to the class of 2023. The tassel was worth the hassle. So congratulations to each and every one of you for persevering and persisting as you matriculated through your rigorous program of study. Today, together, we all want you to know how much we admire your hard work, respect your journey, and acknowledge that you earned your degrees during one of the most challenging times ever to be a college student. Going from the classroom to quarantine, and then trying to find a new sense of normal from behind the mask. Nothing about your journey was easy. We see you. A few of you will graduate summa cum laude. Some of you will graduate magna cum laude. Many of you will graduate cum laude. And the rest of you will graduate, oh, laude, thank you, laude. To all of you who have arrived early and stayed late to cross the finish line, the day has finally come in which your hard work will be publicly rewarded. Today, as the world witnesses you receiving your degrees, you inherit the rich legacy of those who came before you and are added to the roster of notable LeMoyne Owen alumni. The question you must ask yourself now is simple. What is life? The answer isn't simple, but it's clear. Life is an opportunity. Benefit from it. Life is beauty. Admire it. Life is a challenge. Meet it. Life is a duty. Complete it. Life is a game. Play it. Life is sorrow. Overcome it. Life is a song. Sing it. Life is a struggle. Accept it. Life is an adventure. Dare it. Life is life. Live it. Because two of the most important days of your life are the day that you were born and the day that you find out why. You must do the thing that you could not do because time is free. But it's priceless. The great scholar William Leonard Roberts II, better known as Rick Ross, said in his book, The Perfect Day to Boss Up, that he knows the expensive jewelry like the diamond-encrusted watches he wears are status symbols in our culture, but he wears them to represent the most valuable resource on earth, time. Once you lose time, you can never get it back. So make sure you use your time wisely and are intentional with your time all the time. Each one of you had to overcome challenges to get to this very place today, even when people didn't believe in you. And worse, in the midst of folks encouraging you to give up, put your degree to the side and finish up later. But you persevered. In the middle of your matriculation through college, you encountered a global pandemic. Something that generally only happens once a century. Quickly, you were thrust into isolation, then quarantined. COVID-19 affected different people in different ways. But one uniting consequence is that it forced many of us to consider how we use our time. Despite all this, you took all the necessary steps to receive your degree on this day, and that is something worth celebrating. It is just as important as celebrating singers, producers, recording engineers, and mixers nominated for a Grammy Award, or better yet, celebrating the ones who win the Golden Statue. Today's graduation ceremony is monumental because it highlights your investment, a feat that no one can take away from you. The only reason that I'm standing here today is because I was where you are. I was just a girl who grew up in New York and went to public school. When it was time for me to apply to college, a guidance counselor told me that I had lofty goals and that I likely would not get accepted into the schools that I identified. And here I am today, a Spelman College alumni, and a University of Pennsylvania alumni, a diversity executive who has worked for major global brands like Starbucks, the National Basketball Association, and currently at the Recording Academy, which is home of the Grammys. A mother to three small children under the age of 7 who don't quite understand that I am working to improve their future work environments so they don't have to experience the racism, sexism, ageism, and whatever ism you can think of that we endure today. Here I am addressing the LeMoyne Owen graduating class of 2023. My guidance counselor told me that I should consider going into a career in cosmetology with the aspiration of renting a booth at a local hair salon. Out of shock and disappointment and pure curiosity, I asked her to explain why I shouldn't apply to the colleges that I set my eyes on for years, especially because I had been inducted into the National Honor Society. She told me, "While you are a smart girl here, those schools might be too hard for you, too out of your reach." Some of you may have been given similar counsel and had individuals try to deflate your spirit and reroute your dreams with their negativity by telling you what you can't do. But here's why I'm so proud of the class of 2023. You blocked out the noise. You buckled down. You stayed focused. You surrounded yourselves with positive people. You believed in your ability to do whatever you put your mind to. And here you are, headed to the next phase of your journey. To quote another great scholar, Kendrick Lamar, he said, "People have to go through trials and tribulations to get where they're at. Do your thing, continue to rock it, because obviously God wants you here." I want to share a story with you about an experience I had as an undergraduate over 20 years ago, even though I don't look like it. This experience was so profound that it impacted my life and ultimately helped give me the courage to set sail on many adventures through uncharted waters. My first boat ride through these waters took place in 2014 when I became the first Chief Diversity and Inclusion Officer in the National Basketball Association, representing the Atlanta Hawks franchise. I didn't have a compass to help me navigate the rocky waves, but nearly 9 years later, I have witnessed 28 of the 30 NBA teams install Chief Diversity Officers. I have been able to repeat this work at a global communications firm, Edelman, a once small coffee startup that is now the world's largest coffee house chain, Starbucks, and now at the Grammys, where I make sure that the voices of our members of color, women, LGBTQIA+, disabled, and next gen, like most of you, get equal opportunities within the music industry. One day, when I was a little bit younger than you, my English professor entered the classroom and told us that she would be giving us a surprise test. My classmates and I waited anxiously at our desks for the test to begin, unsure if we were prepared to provide the right answers, and more importantly, hoping that we would not fail. My professor then handed out the test paper with the text facing down so we could all begin the assignment at the same time. Once she handed them out, she said, "Flip the page and start." To everyone's surprise, there were no questions, just a black dot in the center of the page. My professor carefully examined the expressions on our faces and told us the following. She said, "I want you to write what you see there." Of course, we were confused, but we got started on this mysterious task. Toward the end of class, my professor took all of the answer papers and started reading each one of them out loud for all of us to hear. All of them, with no exceptions, described the black dot, trying to explain its position in the middle of the sheet. But after all of them had been read out loud, my classmates and I were still confused. My professor began to explain, "I am not going to grade you on this. I just wanted to give you something to think about. No one wrote about the white part of the paper. Instead, everyone focused on the black dot, and the same thing happens in our lives. We have a white paper to observe and enjoy,
but we always focus on the dark spots. I left that class transformed, determined to see the empty space where something new was possible, something unwritten, unsaid, not done before. We are living in a moment where black dots are all around us. We watched the video where Tyree Nichols was being brutally beaten by the Memphis police officers who were hired to protect citizens. Most recently, the state of Tennessee received a lot of national attention. Just days after the unspeakable horrors of the Covenant shooting, the state expelled two black legislators, Justin Jones and Justin Pearson, for echoing the sufferings of the very people they represent. It is important to understand that this moment, which captured the national spotlight, did not begin last month or even this year, but rather somewhere along the way with the gradual erosion of our democratic power. Those events will be dark spots that people may try to erase in our history books, but we have the power to persevere and overcome them. Our life is a gift given to us by God with love and care. And we always have reasons to celebrate. Nature renewing itself every day. Our family and friends around us. The house we live in. The food that is provided for us to eat. The job that provides our livelihood. The miracles we see every day. However, we insist on focusing only on the dark spots. The health issues that bother us. The lack of money. The complicated relationship with a family member, and the disappointment with a friend. Of course, those dark spots are very small compared to everything that we have in our lives, but they are the ones that pollute our minds. Take your eyes away from the dark spots in life. Instead, enjoy each one of your blessings, each moment that life gives you. Graduates, be grateful for all of your blessings. And demonstrate gratitude in all of your actions, big and small. Give and receive love, and utilize that power to help people understand that our differences should not keep us apart. Rather, they should bring us together. Make this world a better place tomorrow than it is today by positively impacting others. Don't be judgmental, for we all have imperfections. Be risk takers. And don't be afraid to travel the road not taken, because you are uniquely positioned to pave a path for many who will come after you. Be kind and keep compassion at the core of all your interactions with others. Most of all, be happy. Everyone wants happiness. No one wants pain. But you can't have a rainbow without a little rain. Congratulations and long live the LeMoyne Owen College class of 2023.
Whereas by awarding honorary degrees, LeMoyne Owen College recognizes noteworthy individuals whose accomplishments are of such excellence that they serve as a beacon of inspiration to our graduates. By honoring these individuals, the institution is honored as well. Whereas Mrs. Nzinga Shaw exemplifies the standard of excellence LeMoyne Owen College deems worthy of this recognition. Ms. Shaw, we are grateful for your presence and honored that you accepted our invitation to address our graduates, alumni, friends, supporters, faculty, and staff. We truly appreciate your words of wisdom. It is my distinct honor and pleasure to present Ms. Shaw an honorary Doctorate of Humane Letters degree. I direct that you be vested with the hood appropriate to this degree. Now, therefore, by the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, I do confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters and admit you to all rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Dr. Shaw, welcome to the LeMoyne Owen College family. In addition to today's honor bestowed by LeMoyne Owen College, the city of Memphis also has a special recognition to present to Ms. Shaw. Trustee Mikhail Lowry, chairman of the Shelby County Board of Commissioners, will come forward for the presentation.
Thank you so much. On behalf of the Shelby County Board of Commissioners, I'm chairman of the Board of Commissioners, and I'm also, because Ms. Shaw said to say it proud, so I'm a proud graduate of LeMoyne Owen College. And Ms. Shaw, now that you've received your doctorate, you can now also claim LeMoyne Owen College as well. So welcome to the family. But on behalf of the Shelby County Board of Commissioners, we want to honor Ms. Shaw for all of her accomplishments. We want to recognize her for continuing to break ceilings and also embodying the sentiment to lift as you climb. So on behalf of the Shelby County Board of Commissioners, we recognize Ms. Shaw for all of her accomplishments, but as well as being our commencement speaker today. Thank you so much.
Will the marshal and the candidates for graduation receiving the Associate of Arts degree please stand and move to the platform? Please hold applause until the names have been called for all of the candidates who are receiving the Associate of Arts degree. Ada Gillen. Scarlett Pickens. You may be seated. Will the marshal and the candidates for graduation receiving the Associate of Science degree Please stand and move to the platform. Will the marshal and the candidates for graduation receiving the Bachelor of Arts degree please stand and move to the platform. John Turner, music. Talisha Shorty, art. Brandon Hunt, art, cum laude. Corian Bronner, art, magna cum laude. Chandler Armstrong, art. Tabitha Barlow, music, magna cum laude. Tamara Williams, music. Demetria Banks, sociology. Stephanie Burton, criminal justice, police. LaQuisha Hurt, sociology. Cameron Hollingshed, music. Harmony Lucas, criminal justice, police concentration. Daria Roby, English. Brianna Hopper, English. Janika Ellington, criminal justice, pre-law concentration, magna cum laude. Marcus Frierson, chemistry, cum laude. Alexandria Lowe, sociology. Tykeria Grissom, political science, cum laude. April Sullivan Taylor, criminal justice, police concentration. Marla Smith, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. Kentavian Lawrence, criminal justice, police concentration. Andrea Martin, criminal justice. Andrea Martin, criminal justice, police concentration. Adriana Merriweth, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. LaVita Valentine, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. Valencia Moody, criminal justice, pre-law. Quadasia Allen, criminal justice, pre-law. Michael Square, criminal justice, police concentration. Reginald Robinson, criminal justice, police concentration. Kiana Edwards, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. Latina Briggs, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. Cherum Gwen Williams, criminal justice, police concentration, summa cum laude. Elijah Coleman, criminal justice, police concentration. Charity Bays, criminal justice, police concentration. Jalen Woodland, criminal justice, cum laude. Kamika Washington, interdisciplinary studies. Teron Clark, criminal justice, police concentration. Paula Chapman, criminal justice, police concentration, magna cum laude. Latika Bennett, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. Gerard Wilson, interdisciplinary studies, cum laude. Andrew Anderson, criminal justice, police concentration. Dunzel Scott, criminal justice, police concentration. Keith McWilliams, criminal justice, police concentration, cum laude. Keith McWilliams is a retired United States veteran who served for 24 years in the U.S. Marine. He is a combat veteran who served in Operation Desert Storm, Operation Iraqi Freedom, and Operation Enduring Freedom. Mr. McWilliams, we thank you for your service. Mark LaSure Sr., criminal justice, police concentration. Mark is a retired homicide sergeant from the Memphis Police Department and is a veteran from the United States Army who served in Operation Just Cause and Desert Storm. Mr. LaSure,
We thank you for your service. You may be seated. Will the marshal and the candidates for graduation receiving the Bachelor of Business Administration degree please stand and move to the platform? Lakia Eggleston, Business Management. Jakeisha Forrest Andrews, Business Management. Ashley Christian, Business Management. Eric Henderson, Business Management. Israel C.J. Muhammad, Business Management. Ronald Snell, better known as Bishop. Business Management. Kimyata Perry, Business Management. Kimberly Tate, Business Management. Jacqueline Johnson, Accounting. Crystal Word, Business Management, cum laude. Mallory Somerville Brown, Business Management. Magna cum laude.
Hello. How are you?
Kimberly Lacey.
Kirby Lacey.
Better known as Kirby Lacey. Business Management. Magna cum laude. Derek Marshall. Business Management. Magna cum laude. Derek is also a graduate of distinction. He is a scholar and he is aspiring to become a minister of the gospel. He is a community leader who helps underprivileged children by providing backpacks, school supplies, groceries for the less fortunate, and distributes meals to the homeless shelters. It's important to note that Mr. Marshall's church, New Life of Memphis Church, recently made a financial contribution to LeMoyne Owen College to help support the longevity of our HBCUs. Arisha Mitchell,
Business Management. Naaman Smith Jr., Business Management. Alana Tate, Business Management. You may be seated. Will the marshal and the candidates for graduation receiving the Bachelor of Science degree please stand and move to the platform? Please hold applause until the names have been called for all of the candidates who are receiving the Bachelor of Science degree. Denisha Timmons, Computer Science, Information Assurance, and Cyber Defense Concentration, cum laude. Kiana Shaw, Biology. Iyanla McNeil, Biology. Kaylin Howard, Graduate of Distinction, Biology, magna cum laude. Ms. Howard is a scholar and a student athlete who has been on the dean's and president's list throughout her tenure here at the college and has the highest grade point average in the natural and mathematical sciences division. In addition to Ms. Howard's scholastic achievement, Kaylin has served in the Union Mission Kitchen, distributed items for the homeless, and participated in numerous mentoring opportunities in the Commons community. Graduate of Distinction, Kaylin Howard. Tyranny Crosby, Biology. Jayla Merriweather, Biology, cum laude. Mykia Chisholm, Biology. Tamika Stewart, Interdisciplinary Studies.
Alexander Rishandrix.
Alexander Rishon Wilkes, Social Work. Will Vessing, social work. Kiana Hall, social work. Yurin Mador, computer science, summa cum laude. Yurin Mador is a graduate of distinction. In her freshman year, she worked with the University of Memphis as a data science intern. During her sophomore year, she worked with Spotify, a music streaming company, as a product design intern in New York. In her junior year, she worked with Wish, an e-commerce company, as a product design intern in San Francisco. Also in her junior year, she worked with Slack, a tech company owned by Salesforce, as a product design intern in San Francisco. And I'm happy to state that at the end of her internship with Slack, she was given a full offer to work with them as a product designer in San Francisco. Nelson Mukuka, biology, magna cum laude. Tavius Anderson, computer science, information assurance, and cyber defense concentration. Diamond West, interdisciplinary studies. Jamal Muhammad, computer science, information assurance, and cyber defense concentration, magna cum laude. Charles Maxwell, information technology. Kenya Gillenwaters, concentration in biology. Charles Elliott Jr., interdisciplinary studies. Dominique Williams, interdisciplinary studies. Tatiana Richards, interdisciplinary studies. Jaya Webster, interdisciplinary studies. Magna cum laude. Courtney Harris, interdisciplinary studies, cum laude. Jaya Webster, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Courtney Harris, Interdisciplinary Studies, cum laude. Carla Henderson, Social Work. Tarina Hunter, Social Work. Crystal Boyce, Social Work. Courtney Calhoun, Interdisciplinary Studies. Keithia Turner, Social Work. LaDestiny Williams, Social Work. Tamar Anderson, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Ms. Anderson is a graduate of distinction. She's also a student athlete. She is a member of the esteemed W.E.B. Du Bois Honors Program. She's a mathematics major. During COVID, she obtained an internship with Idea Edge Cliff Preparatory School in Fort Worth, Texas, where she formed many partnerships and friends. She believes that magic doesn't stop once the goal is reached. It continues with perseverance and dedication to become what God destined her to be, which was embedded within her at LeMoyne Owen College. Akaya Cusick, Interdisciplinary Studies. Diana Scott, Interdisciplinary Studies. Jamario Brown, Interdisciplinary Studies. Jada Robinson, Interdisciplinary Studies. Felicia Smith, Interdisciplinary Studies. Tiana White, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Jaleesa Wallace, Interdisciplinary Studies. Shondell Mabone, Interdisciplinary Studies. Latifa Porter, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Ashley Harrison, Interdisciplinary Studies. Lakeisha Bass, Interdisciplinary Studies. Tyler Foster, Interdisciplinary Studies. Tyrese Love, Interdisciplinary Studies.
It's Asia Rose Wakefield.
Asia Rose Wakefield, Interdisciplinary Studies. Brianna Boyce, Interdisciplinary Studies, magna cum laude. Jasmine Phillips, Interdisciplinary Studies, cum laude.
My car fell in the toilet, so they told me to write it on here.
Mahogany Gwynn, Interdisciplinary Studies. Michael Joe, Computer Science, Information Assurance and Cyber Defense Concentration, summa cum laude. You may be seated. Will the members of the class of 2023 who are to receive the Associate of Arts degree please stand? Will the members of the class of 2023 who are receiving the Associate of Science degree please stand?
On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, I now confer upon you the degree Associate of Science and admit to you all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies You may now turn your tassels. Please be seated.
Will the members of the class of 2023 who are to receive the Bachelor of Arts degree please stand?
On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, I now confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts and admit you to all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Ladies and gentlemen, you may now turn your tassels. Please be seated.
Will the members of the class of 2023 who are to receive the Bachelor of Business Administration degree, please stand.
On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, I now confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration and admit you to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Ladies and gentlemen, you may now turn your tassels. Please be seated.
Will the members of the class of 2020 who are to receive the Bachelor of Science degree please stand?
On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, I now confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Science and admit you to all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Ladies and gentlemen, you may now turn your tassels. Please be seated. The legacy of the Dr. Theodore Roosevelt McLemore continues to live on in the hearts and minds of the LeMoyne Owen College family. As an advocate for education and service, he dedicated his life to changing the landscape of the college. LeMoyne Owen College honors the memory of Dr. McLemore with the annual presentation of the T.R. McLemore Awards. The Award of Excellence in Teaching salutes an outstanding full-time faculty member with three or more years of service whose efforts have made a difference in the lives of students. Dr. McLemore's contributions to LeMoyne Owen College can never be overstated, and this award is a fitting tribute to his excellence as an alumnus, trustee, philanthropist, and community servant. Today we have Sherry McIntyre Howard, class of 2001, and family representative for the McLemore family. Mrs. Howard, please stand. Voted by his or her by her fellow faculty members, this year's recipient of the T.R. McLemore Award is Dr. Zena Parker. In her absence, we'd like to recognize Dr. Parker. At this time, it's time to recognize alumni classes. Will the members of the Diamond Anniversary Class of 1963? Anyone here? Please stand. Fabulous. Happy anniversary. Looking good, aren't they? God. It's that magic, right? It's the magic. At this time, we'd like to recognize the golden anniversary class of 1973. Please stand. Congratulations. And finally, we'd like to recognize the members of the silver anniversary class of 1998. Will you stand at this time? Congratulations. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of LeMoyne Owen College, I now salute the class of 1963 on their diamond anniversary, the class of 1973 on their golden anniversary, and the class of 1998 on their silver anniversary. Certificates of recognition for your contributions to LeMoyne Owen College and your communities will be presented to each of you. Thank you for your continuing support of your alma mater, and may God continue to bless you.
Greetings, Madam President, Board of Trustees, Ms. Nzinga Saw, Reverend Watkins, distinguished guests in the class of 2023, I am Alandria London, second vice president for the LeMoyne Owen College National Alumni, and I'm here on behalf of President Ms. Kristen Heron Hurd, and I bring you greetings. If Reverend Dr. James L. Netter Sr. were here with us today, he would be celebrating his 60th diamond anniversary of graduating from LeMoyne Owen College with the class of 1963. Reverend Netter's, Reverend Netter's was very instrumental in bringing the faith-based community and LeMoyne Owen College together. 65 years ago, he helped establish the Baptist International Tea, which was an annual fundraiser that brings additional support to the college. We should all be like Reverend Netter's and give back to our dear old college home. Prior to COVID-19 pandemic, the college would hold its annual commencement ceremony here at Mount Vernon Baptist Church, and Reverend Netter's would be on cloud nine. He was so proud to have his alma mater hold the ceremony here. So a personal thank you to Reverend James Netter's for opening his door to his college, and to Reverend Melvin Watkins for asking us to come on home. Yeah. With the members of the class of 2023 and the honorary degree recipients, please stand and raise your right hand. On behalf of the LeMoyne Owen College National Association, I commend you on your academic accomplishments and welcome you to the world's greatest organization. As president of this prestigious body, I charge each of you the responsibility of preserving the legacy, supporting and promoting our alma mater and its mission, and to forever be committed to service, consecration, and truth. If you so promise, please say, I do. Welcome.
Congratulations, graduates. I hope you can appreciate the moment and take time to truly appreciate the magnitude of your accomplishments. I also want you to stop and take a moment to thank every member of your community, every parent, every family member and friend, the alumni that have helped guide you along the way. Thank you to the faculty and for your instruction and academic excellence, and the staff who truly kept the engine of LeMoyne Owen College running. Please join me in thanking our Board of Trustees for their leadership and support. Trustees are a critical aspect of an institution's success. At this time, I'd like to recognize and express my gratitude to two whose terms are ending and who are proud magicians who have advocated for LOC in their workplace, in the community, and within their personal networks. Trustee Larry Miller, please stand. From the class of 1977, Trustee Larry Miller's impact and advocacy for LeMoyne Owen College and HBCUs has been transformational. His work on the HBCU Wellness Project allowed us to develop the college in so many ways through hiring staff and updating our technology infrastructure. His impact will continue to advance the college. Thank you, Trustee Miller. Trustee Mikhail Lowry, will you please stand? From the class of 2000, Trustee Mikhail Lowry's advocacy for LOC has resulted in $1.5 million in support from the County Commission. His golf tournament has not only raised golfers' games, it's also raised almost $50,000 in just 2 years. We appreciate your service and dedication to the college, Trustee Mikhail Lowry. As the 153rd LeMoyne Owen College commencement comes to a close, we would also like to thank Mr. Gavin Wigginson, our distinguished soloists, Ms. Tabitha Barlow and Ms. Tamira Williams, and Dr. Ashley Davis, the accompanists. We thank the members of the commencement committee for their execution of this commencement ceremony. And a special thank you to Mount Vernon Missionary Baptist Church, Westwood. We thank you for allowing us to come back home. Thank you to Dr. Nzinga Shaw for your exceptional address to our graduates. I also want to take a moment to recognize our inaugural class of Operation Graduation. Operation Graduation is a cohort of seniors who've taken the extra step to prepare themselves for life beyond graduation. These students have attended one-on-one sessions with our Career Services Director, Dr. Robert Williams, and our Vice President of Student Affairs, Dr. Tara Dunn Ross, to get individualized training in their field of interest. They've taken the extra mile to ensure they are equipped for career placement or accepted into graduate or professional school. These students are recognized today with an emblem of success on their regalia. Will the Operation Graduation inaugural cohort please stand? Thank you for your commitment to your future. After the singing of the alma mater and following the benediction given by Reverend Melvin D. Watkins, Jr., the audience is asked to be seated for the recessional. Will the audience please stand for the alma mater at this time?
If you have a praise in your heart right now, give that praise to God. Give God your best. Give God your best hallelujah. I said, give God your best praise. Give him some glory here because he's worthy to be praised. We're so grateful to God right now. It's never too early to decide to become a LeMoyne Owen College student. If you're a young person in this room here today and you have enjoyed all of what you saw, all of the celebration, and there's a hole in the carpet right here, right now, and you've enjoyed all of that, but behind all of the celebration, brilliant students have worked very hard, and it's never too early to decide to become a LeMoyne Owen College graduate. And it's never too late. So if you're here now and you have an interest of becoming a student of the great LeMoyne Owen College, be sure to go to loc.edu, call the school, and they will direct you from there. And somebody said, amen. Amen. Let us have benediction. Now, God, unto you who art able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before your presence with exceeding joy. To you, the only wise God, our Savior, let there be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever is our prayer. And the people of God said, amen, amen, and amen.
you.